answer to poverty. My colleagues in public admin.
A warm welcome to all freshmen of the College of Business and Public Administration. I am Dr. Cynthia Manalat, the area chairperson of the Bachelor of Science and Entrepreneurship program. You are now entering a new chapter of your lives, one that you will write in your 4 years of stay in your chosen program. I would be lying if I told you that college life is easy. It is full of obstacles, hardships, and challenges. Do not let this get you down. Instead, use this as your motivation to press on and pursue what you have chosen. For through these hardships and challenges, unbreakable friendships and invaluable knowledge shall bloom. The road is strenuous and long, but it is worth every effort you exert. This, I assure you, your college life will greatly contribute in molding you as a person and will ultimately prepare you to face the real world when the time comes. Our program objectives. After the completion of the program, the graduates of the Bachelor of Science and Entrepreneurship shall be able to conduct a self-assessment to determine the level of entrepreneurial competencies, analyze and scan the environment to assess business opportunities and develop their profitability profiles from which entrepreneurial ventures can be selected from. Prepare a business plan. Mobilize the necessary human, financial, logistical, and technical resources to implement the business plan. Prepare and comply with the requirements for business operations. Operate and manage the business enterprise, observing good governance and social responsibility. And apply entrepreneurial management in any organization other than. I would like you to meet our esteemed faculty who will guide you in your journey. They will be your second parents, mentors, and role models. First, we have Dr. Melba Asuncion, a Doctor of Business Administration. She obtained her master's degree in business administration at the Polytechnic University of the Philippines, where she also attained her bachelor's degree in accountancy. Her field of expertise in accounting and auditing, especially in government offices. Recently, she serves as the board of director of the Association of Government Internal Auditors Incorporated and an accreditor of Accrediting Agency of Chartered Colleges and Universities of the Philippines, the AAPU. Now we have Professor Annalyn Veneceda. She got her Bachelor of Science in Commerce, major in Economics at the Far Eastern University. She obtained her Master's in Business Administration at Eloy Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology. She specializes in economics and entrepreneurships. Her career spans for 14 years and serves as the secretary for the president of IRIS for 4 years. She is also a practitioner aside from being a professor, as she also owns a business herself. Next is Professor Maria Lourdes Gomez. She holds a master's degree in business administration from Eulogio Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology. Professor Gomez is a homegrown talent, as she also obtained her Bachelor's of Science degree in Technopreneurship at our school. Her areas of expertise are in the areas of entrepreneurship and management. Next is Professor Maria Teresa G. Madagan. Professor Madagan holds a master's degree in business administration from Eulogio Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology. She obtained her bachelor's degree in secretarial administration from the University of Makati. Her expertise are in the areas of financial management, marketing, and accounting. She is also the current advisor of the Entrepreneurial Management Society, a college-based organization specially for BS Entrepreneurship Program. Next, we have Dr. John D. D. Guzman. He is a graduate of Mechanical Engineering at the Mapua Institute of Technology. He obtained his doctorate degree in Business Administration at the Pamantasan ng Lusod ng Maynila and his doctorate degree in Educational Management and Doctor of Philosophy from Eulogio Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology. His areas of expertise are in the field of business and education. Next, we have Professor Ronaline Joy Mercado. Professor Mercado is a certified public accountant and is currently connected as an admin employee of the Eulogio Amang Rodriguez Institute of Science and Technology. She is part now of the BS Entrepreneurship Program, teaching and handling accounting subjects. Next is we have Professor Christopher Cahayon, is a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Accountancy at the Polytechnic University of the Philippines and is currently the director of the Resource Generation Office. He's going to handle subjects in accounting and probably law, specifically for the program of Bachelor of Science in Entrepreneurship. Next, we have Professor Ches Simonan. He obtained his Master in Business Administration in IRIS and is a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Accountancy at the Arellano University of the Philippines. He is currently connected with AutoHub Group of Companies as Finance and Treasury Senior Manager. His expertise is in the field of accounting and management. Our professors are responsible for developing our learning collaterals and ensures that it is up to date and aligned with the current industry realities. They also conduct research, which they present in local and international platforms. Once again, I welcome all freshmen. You are fortunate to be able to conduct face-to-face classes again. I hope you do not waste this chance to maximize the potential to learn. I urge each and every one of you, do your best. Have fun in what you do and keep on pushing towards your goals and dreams. Mabuhay.
Again, that was Dr. Cynthia Manalad from Bachelor of Science in Entrepreneur.
So partner, excited ka na ba sa ating intermission? May idea ka na ba?
Actually, meron na. Very, very much excited to see the talented CBPNs. So before we move on to another part of the program, partner, let's have an intermission number from one of the talented committees. Guys, let's give them a big round of virtual applause.
Oh, sa isip mo. Kung mahal mo na rin ba ako, isayaw mo ako sa gitna ng ulan, mahal ko. Gawin ang lahat para sa'yo. Kapalit man ito'y buhay ko. Alam kong mahal mo na rin ako.
Wow, what a wonderful intermission we have. So let's give again a virtual round of applause to our talent committees. Partners?
Grabe, ang lamig ng boses. Nilalamig ako bigla.
Oh, parang rep lang.
Ang taas ng araw pero nilamig ako, partner. Grabing serenade naman yan.
So I'd like to call on the AU Chair of Human Resource Management and Development, Dr. Charlene Escayo. So habang hinihintay pa natin ang from anong area chair from PSPA, Human Resource Management and Development, na si Dr. Escayo, kwentuhan muna tayo, partner.
Sure, partner. Siyempre, kakatapos lang ng bakasyon natin. So we started this year with a stand, with the simulation program, right? Monday na Monday, very much energetic ang mga tao dito sa comment section.
So sa mga tao sa comment section natin, excited na ba kayo para sa ating sa paparating na klase natin?
Excited na ba ang lahat sa paparating na face-to-face, guys?
Ikaw ba, partner? Excited ka na ba sa paparating na face-to-face?
Actually, partner, yes. Yes, excited na po ako. Excited na akong makita yung mga magaganda at pogi nating ano, ka-campus mates.
Sure bang
balik ako? Sure balik ako, madaming magaganda, lalo na sa ano, bang course yun? Office administration.
Yes, kaway-kaway.
Kaway-kaway.
Ay, syempre, hindi pa patalo ang marketing management.
Yeah. Yes. Madaming pogi. Madami bang mga magaganda at pogi?
Madami
pogi. No? Pero balita ko, madaming matatalino sa entrepreneurship management students. Tama ba yung chismis?
Ako mukhang tama ata yan. Hindi lang sila nagsasalita. Low-key lang sila.
Mukhang hinihintay talaga natin yung F2F para mang spot ng mga matatalino at mga gwapo at magaganda. Napaghahalataan, partner. Ayan, namumukadkad ang color blue sa ating comment section. And the color blue hearts are for entrepreneurship management students. Hi, guys!
So, partner, tanungin lang kita, partner.
Go ahead, partner.
Anong naaalala mo sa nung face-to-face? Nakaranas ka ba ng face-to-face?
Actually, partner, kami yung ano, first, so incoming second year ako ngayon, hindi ko naranasan mag face-to-face. So, ang huling face-to-face ko was way back senior high school. So, medyo kabado sa paparating na F2F. Ikaw ba, partner? Was there any most memorable experience noong F2F mo?
Nga ba? Madami akong memorable ng face-to-face. Siyempre, andun yung maghahanap pa ng mga crush mo. May naging spot ng mga koki, ganun.
Actually, masaya nga yan. Mga pogi at magaganda, no?
Lalo na madaming pogi sa sa College of Business and Public Administration.
Hi, actually, may nagpapa-shoutout dito. Hi, si John Roy Fadrikela ng Public Ad.
Tapos sabi naman ni Francis na spot ko din dito sa live chat natin sa YouTube. For the pogi ang hunting. Siyempre, ganun talaga. Para may inspiration. So, ito na nga. Ito na nga si... I'd like to call on Dr. Charlene Escario, Area Chair from BSBA Human Resource Development and Management.
So, Zoom yan.
I will be sharing the Human Resource Management Program Objective. I am Dr. Charlene Escario, and I'll be presenting also the Human Resource Management Faculty Roster. The program objective of the Human Resource Management comprises of to develop a critical thinking skills that permit them to be logically approach and solve problems and recognize opportunities, to enhance their sensitivities to the ethical context of business decisions, handle business relationship with integrity and concern for the product of choice. It provides also students assistance in building their management and communication skills and a frequent opportunities to practice and improve skills in writing. And lastly, the program would like to develop the students in their skills necessary to be successful human resource management personnel, managers, and executive. For the Human Resource Faculty Roosters, we have Dr. Hernan Oliveras, who is currently an OJT coordinator. His specialization is in taxation and accounting subjects. We also have Professor Ronald Doroteo, a Chief Director of Campus Ministry, who handles TQM Strategic Management. And we also have Dr. Ana Victoria Mailas, a full-time faculty who is expert in compensation, benefits, training, and development. We also have Professor Evelyn Celestial, who is a full-time faculty handling accounting subjects. Professor Isaac Ochoterena, whose expert is in labor law relations, obligation, and contract. And Professor Michael Gibaga, the training and development of faculty, full-time faculty, who is also expert in training and development, recruitment, strategic management. We also have Dr. Ricardo Opido, our part-time faculty, who is expert in obligation and contract, law subjects. Professor Jerome Paul Antonio, a part-time faculty, who handles recruitment and selection. Professor Adrian Yasono is a part-time faculty who handles also recruitment and selection subjects. And then we also have Professor Christian Miranda, who is expert is in training and development, project management. And lastly, we have Professor Elaine Terrado. I'll be presenting to you their academic qualifications and educational background. We have Dr. Hernan Oliveros, is a graduate of Doctor of Business Administration from IRIS, an OJT coordinator, affiliated to Navotas Polytechnic College, 15 years in corporate world, and owner of Mislang Management Incorporated. We also have Professor Ronald Doroteo, an MBA graduate. He has units in doctorate degree, who is the Chief of Interfaith, ISO Internal Auditor, Guidance Coordinator affiliated to Navotas Polytechnic College and Colegio de San Juan de Letran. We have Dr. Ana Victoria Miles, who is PhD in Human Resource Management, who has units in Doctor of Business Administration, a full-time faculty, a TESDA assessor, and a trainer. We also have Professor Evelyn Celestial, an MBA graduate, who has also units in Doctor in Public Administration, our full-time faculty, a former Chief of Cultural Affairs Division. We also have Professor Isaac Ochiterena, an MBA graduate who has units in Juris Doctor, a full-time faculty, an advisor of Human Resource Management Society, a license holder of professional tincture, a certified investment solicitor, life and non-life insurance license, certified wealth planner, and certified tax technician. We also have Professor Michael Gibaga, an MBA graduate who has units in Doctor and Business Administrator and units in Juris Doctor, a full-time faculty. We have Dr. Ricardo Upido, a PhD graduate, units in Juris Doctor, a part-time faculty, affiliated to Graduate School of San Sebastian College, Supply Chain Assistant and Manager from the year 2021 to up to present. We have Professor Jerome Paul Antonio, who has units in MBA, who is a part-time faculty affiliated to Legal Office of Acquired Assets of Management Group. We have Professor Adrian Yazona, who has units in MBA, who is a part-time faculty affiliated to Philippine General Hospital Deputy Director for Administration, Occupation, and Health and Safety, an LPT passer. We have Professor Christian Ranche, who is graduate of MBA, units also in Clinical Social Work, in Masters of Arts in Guidance in Counseling and Counseling Psychology, a part-time faculty affiliated to DSWD as Training Specialist, Lecturer of De La Salle National University, a Registered Psychometrician, LPT passer, a book author, and LET reviewer. We have Professor Elaine Joy Torado, an MBA graduate, a part-time faculty who is affiliated to Philippine Science High School as Administrative Officer 2 in Human Resource Management Department and also an LPT passer. Thank you so much for listening.
So thank you, Dr. Charlene Escayo, Area Chair from BSBA Human Resource Development and Management. So, partner, excited ka na ba sa next part of the program natin?
Excited na, intriguing. Kasi ang next part, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, ay games. Hindi ba tama, partner?
Siyempre. Ikaw naman, partner Sam, excited ka na din ba?
Yes naman, super waiting na nga ako dito eh. Lalo na yung mga nasa Zoom at saka lalo na yung nasa FB page at syempre dun sa ating live sa ating YouTube.
So, parang gusto ko na nga lang maging viewers bigla nito kasi ang gaganda ng mga icebreaker nila. So, ano nga ba icebreaker natin today?
Ang ating unang icebreaker ay tinatawag na jumbled letter. So guys, we prepared 3 questions para sa inyong mga viewers. All you need to do is to guess the jumbled letters and type the answer sa comment section down below. Siyempre kasama po yung ating mga Zoom participants. So, galingan nyo po maghula. Ang price po nito ay hahaba po yung buhay nyo.
Grabe naman price yan.
So, simulan na natin. Simulan na natin. Ayan na. Number one. Meron lamang tayong 10 seconds. Ayan. Hala, hindi ako magaling dito, partner. Ano yan?
partner. Parang ano yata to? Hindi ko rin alam. Basta ginagamit siya pang picture. May nakakuha na. Si Miss Angelica Rodriguez. Tama ba? Tama ba yung answer? Let's see.
Tama ba?
Tama! Wow! Ang gagaling naman
siya. Grabe, patulo naman kami dyan.
Alam ko na yung feeling ng may dyslexia. Ganun pala. Next. Next partner. Nainis ako. Hindi ko nahulaan.
Ano naman na. Ang nakatama ata rito sa pagkatingin ko sa cellphone is si Lonnie. Lonnie sa ano, viewers natin from YouTube.
Yan. Plus 100 points for Gryffindor.
Akala ko first 100 points sa ano, sa langit.
For Gryffindor lang, partner. Ano ba yan? Next. And the answer is...
Aaminin ko talaga, partner. Di talaga ako magaling dito.
Ako din eh. Nalilito ako sa letters. And ano ba ang sagot sa number 2? Language.
Language.
Yeah, this time ang daming nakakuha. Tignan ko ngayon sa comment section.
Madaming nakakuha sa ano natin, viewers natin sa YouTube.
Mga very ano oh, nagpa-participate talaga ko, sila oh. Nakuha
hindi
nila.
Hindi ko na makita kung sino yung nauna sa kanila.
Basta guys, tandaan niyo yung prize natin. Plus 100 points sa inyong house. Gryffindor, Slytherin. Next. Last jumbled letter. Yan. And the timer starts now. Ano yan? So pretty. Hindi ko talaga mahulaan, partner.
Makikahirapan talaga. Guys.
Feeling ko talaga, ito yung feeling na may dyslexia eh. Ayan.
So ano angry.
Na? Ah! Nabasa ko na stenography. Kala ko so pretty. Ayan. Ayan na ang last, no, partner? Sana naman nag-enjoy
ay, last
kayo
ba
lahat.
Yun? Ba't parang nabitin ako sa last na yun?
Wala so, kang mag-alala, partner. May next pa tayong ano, mga activities na mas masaya and mas nakaka-enjoy.
Mas maganda ayan. Rin ba yung prize?
Plus 100 points sa langit. Next. All right. Sana naman nag-enjoy yung mga viewers natin, 'di ba?
Nakita ko dito sa YouTube natin, partner, may nag-chat sa live chat natin. Parang
ano
nabitin ata
na
sila. Sabi ni Katrina Castillo, lalas na yun. Nabitin nga sila pagkaya ko, partner.
Sabi naman ni Mark Bonggalbal, last na yun, di man lang ako nakasagot. Sorry, Mark, try again next time.
Malay mo, makabawi ka.
Sabi naman ni Ia Reyes, olat sa keyboarding, bagal mag-type. Hindi ka keyboard warrior, Iya.
Okay lang yan. Practice-practice lang yan, kagaya ko.
Sabi naman ni Christelle, laging daw ang kanyang phone. Bakit time na Christelle para magpatit ang phone? Magbasa pa tayo ng ibang set, ng ibang comments, partner.
Okay. Parang mabuhay na buhay ata sila ngayong na to, oras na to.
Thank you for Sala Patrick na nag-enjoy ka.
Sabi niya, no, HR Mora dyan, shout out daw. Sige, shout out sa'yo.
Shout out. Sabi ni Kayla Marie Estupito, wala po bang TikTokerist? Sorry po, hindi po kami TikTokerist po.
Okay, okay. Ano na ba yung next part of the program natin, partner?
Let's see. So, after the game, let us now move forward to the discussion of the simulation class of online modalities. I would like to call on Professor Benigno Castillo to discuss the topic. Please give him a virtual round of applause.
So, habang hinihintay natin si Sir Castillo, tuloy muna natin yata yung pagbabasa, mga nagsashoutout sa YouTube natin. YouTube, ano natin?
Parang gusto ko yan, partner. May nag-birthday na dito, tignan ko. Hmm.
Grabe yung birthday na birthday. Monday naman.
Ay, nawala na yung nag-birthday. Pasensya na, comment ka na lang ulit para mabasa natin. Happy birthday sa'yo. Ayan, happy, sabi happy ni Almira, birthday. Sabi ni Almira Joy Escreza, shout out daw sa mga Pokemon girls.
Grabe. Hello, 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 Miss Lai. Hello? Miss MC, hello, number sir. One? Nala ba yung slide yan na na-submit ko? Slide number one?
Wait lang po, Sir Castillo.
Ayan, nandun na. Okay, to all, first year, Iris CBPA, second year, third year, fourth year, welcome and welcome back to Iris. Okay, before we start no, the presentation, I would like also to greet the mga guwapo, nagagandahan at talented na mga estudyante ng CBPA. But be sure na kailangan natin obserbahan ang ating pagpasok at saka paglabas ng ating eskwelahan. So welcome back. Here's what you can expect. Number one, updated gallery hours. Sa mga pagpasok ninyo, kailangan po pagdating sa Paul Blas, face-to-face this coming November. Okay, so kailangan yung oras ng pagpasok, kailangan yung schedule natin, ay dapat natin sundin. At siyempre, yung 6 feet social distancing, practice natin. Nanireremind yan lagi. At saka, pagpasok nyo, yung temperature natin na kailangan, okay, below 37 degrees. And also, follow the entry and exit door natin sa ating kolehiyo. And observe also the sanitation. Bring your sanitizers, yung alcohol, dapat dalhin po. At higit sa lahat, magdala ng mga basahan para malinisan ng ating mga upuan. Okay, so increase cleanliness lagi. Okay, slide number 2. Next. Okay, these are the 6 things we must ensure to go back to school safely. So number one, personal protective equipment available for every student and also the faculties. So kailangan magdala po tayo ng ating mga face mask, okay, ating alcohol, okay, lagi natin, okay, laging handa, okay, always prepared. Number two, cleaning and disinfecting protocols must be in place. Yan, kailangan nasa ayos po, no? Lagi. At also, number 3, 6 feet of social distancing must be required inside school buildings. Okay, so kailangan, okay, lagi tayong, okay, 6 feet. Okay, ang ating social distancing. Medyo maghiwalay po tayo, no? Then number 4, accommodation must be available for student and the faculty or staff who are at high risk. So kung may nararamdaman kayo, mga estudyante namin, especially first year, but second year, third year, and fourth year, all students of CBPA, nandyan po yung ating mga ating medical and dental. Okay, doon po, located at ground floor sa engineering building. Yan, kailangan alamin nyo po. No? Number 5, school districts or school ng ating department must ensure they have adequate mental health services. Nandun po ang ating mga medical and dental staff na ready po for students, especially meron din silang mga logbook na gagamitin. Okay? Then number 6, equitable access to a well-rounded education for every student regardless of what reopening looks like. So kailangan po, siyempre, ipapaalala namin sa inyo, especially po sa mga first year, but not only the first year, second year, third and fourth year, must be observed na lagi po tayong, okay, alalahanin at huwag natin ipagkait na sabihan ng ating mga estudyante, especially the CSE students, to monitor our students po. Nandyan din kayo nakahalili ng ating kuleyo, ating mga CSG officers, mayors of bawat programs, nandyan din po kayo para po nagiging alerto tayo kung meron man na huwag naman sana, lalo na itong poll blast na face-to-face natin. So, mag-ingat tayo, step in, stand out, and step up. Okay, good morning to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Benigno Castillo, for sharing to us the safety and health protocols. Ngayon papalapit na ang F2F.
So, ang next natin is let's call on the AU Chair of Public Administration, Dr. Leonora Divina. Ay, okay na pala. So, next natin is, excited ka na ba sa next natin? Intermission ulit tayo nito, partner.
Siyempre naman, I enjoy watching our talented classmates and mga iristians kasi yan, kaya talented sila.
Siyempre, di pa patalo tayo na pagdating sa mga talented students. So, let's have another intermission number made by one of our talented committees again. Let's give them a virtual round of applause. Another malamig na naman. Ramdam talaga ang Pasko na nito. Malamig na sino na ha.
The YouTube Music app has playlists for every mood. Tanghaling tapat, nilalamig ako, partner. Grabe yung boses. Parang soul voice. Di ba? I really enjoyed the intermission number, partner.
Ikaw ba? Ano mo ba sasabi mo, MC number 2 sa...
Ay, iba din talaga. Tanghaling tapat. Nangingibabaw ang yelo. Tirik na tirik ang araw, pero nangingibabaw ang yelo. Pero ang galing nilang kumanta lahat.
So, mas nakaka-excite yung sunod na ano natin dito, part ng program. Since nabitin sila sa unang ano natin, sa unang icebreaker natin, bakit di natin sundan ulit ng pangalawang icebreaker?
Tama, tama yan.
Yes, partner. Ano nga ba yung next? Yung icebreaker number 2. May idea ba kayo, guys?
Nakakabulol siya. Nakakabulol bang yun?
Tama. So, kung nahirapan tayo kanina sa jumbled letters, feeling ko mas mahihirapan tayo dito. Grabe.
Ano nga ba ang ano natin, icebreaker number 2 natin, partner?
The next icebreaker would be called gibberish. So, familiar ba kayo yung katunog na words ay huhulaan?
Ano nga ba yun? Ano nga ba yun, partner?
Ay, tignan na lang partner? Natin. I-check na lang natin. Let's move on to the next icebreaker. Yan, I encourage everyone po to join, lalo na yung mga Zoom participants and mga
ano
YouTube viewers.
And partner.
Eto, huhulaan mo kung ano yung ano ba, yung words.
Anong price natin, partner?
Ang price natin ay yung ano, yung sa The Lord of the Rings, yung sabi, my precious, yun ang ating price. Kaya galingan nyo, guys. Ayan.
Number 1, may nakahula na ba?
Let's check the comment section. The Rust the Process. Ano yan? The Rust the Process.
The Rust the Process.
Tama nga ang ano ko hula ko, nakakabulol nga siya.
Trust the Process. Ayan. Pala.
So ang sagot ay Trust the Process. Tama nga naman, partner, no? Sa life, let's just trust the process. The next one is?
May idea na ba kayo?
Wala. Ano yan? Nelly earn to earn less, not to queue it. Parang gusto ko ng barbecue. Ayan na. Hulaan nyo yan, guys. Hindi ko yan alam.
Basta nadulog ba, kayo ba?
Ang gagaling ng mga Zoom participants natin, ha? Nakikita ko talagang sila yung nauna, eh.
Sorry, hindi pa matalo ang Team YouTube.
Oo nga, sa Team YouTube din, ang dami na rin nakakuha ng sagot. The answer is, learn to rest, not to quit.
Siyempre, laban lang ng laban.
Tama. Okay. Magpapahinga, pero hindi susuko.
Alright,
and
next.
And to the last... Oh, wala, ano yan? Eve and the Arches the... Night will end. And the sun will rise. Okay. Nosebleed.
Parang pahaba ng pahaba. Yung mamaya ata sa number 5 essay na.
Sino po gumawa nito? I just wanna talk po. Sino po gumawa? Grabe naman po yan.
Siguro pang essay na ata.
Time's up. Essay. Walang nakahula. Seed it daw. Ayan na, even the dark night will end and the sun will rise.
Ang wow. Daming nagre-reklamo sa YouTube natin, ba't ang haba daw ng number 3?
May galit ata yung naglagay niyan sa icebreaker. Grabe naman po yun. Alright, guys, did you enjoy the second icebreaker, the gibberish? Mas mahirap siya sa last one, ano, partner?
Sobrang hirap. Maski ako
wala
di
ako nahulaan. Wala ako nahulaan.
So ano nga ba next natin sa program na to? May idea ka
right.
na ba, Sam?
Ako, wala din ako eh. Hindi, syempre meron.
Okay. After that very fun and exciting icebreaker, let us now move on to the next part of the program. The next topic that we will be discussing would be the creation of the CBPA Google account. I would like to call on Mr. Joel Reyes to discuss the said topic. Everyone, please give him a virtual round of applause.
Habang hinihintay natin si Sir Joel for creating CBPA Google account, may nagpapa-shoutout dito. Sabi daw dito is shoutout team dishwasher. Grabe naman yung ano na yun. Pangalan ng team nila.
Sabi naman dito ni Maika Nicole, happy birthday Shazney Sanchez, Lenny Abonite, and Gizli San Antonio ng BSOA 3B. Happy birthday, guys! Happy, happy birthday.
Ako, partner mo, ready na yata si Sir Joel. Ready na po ba?
Alright.
Joel?
Okay, so pa-share na lang nung screen ko. Live kasi ako eh.
Alright, again guys, please give Sir Joel a virtual round of applause. Listen to ASMR sounds with your screen off and relax uninterrupted.
Try our family plan. Okay, share ko lang yung screen. Hindi ako makapag-share kasi merong para disable muna yung nasa screen kasi mag-share ako. Share ko yung live na yun. Okay, so thank you. Okay, so para sa lahat ng first year, actually yung mga generation natin ngayon, alam naman natin how to create Gmail account. Okay, so type lang natin yung create Google account. So click ko lang, medyo mabagal kasi yung internet dito. So konti lang naman idadagdag natin. Majority dito kasi ay... Wait lang ha, kasi maingay yung kabilang linya. So, pinamute ko lang yung speaker kasi nag-e-echo yung boses ko. Anyway, so click natin yung for myself. Okay, so dito, syempre name. Kunwari ako, Joel, and then Reyes. So, username ilalagay natin dito. Reyes. Okay, pwedeng ganyan. Reyes Joel. Okay, dot CBPA. Okay, so uniform dapat tayo. Para doon sa mga first year na nakikinig ngayon, uniform dapat tayo. So, lalagyan na natin ang password dito. Okay, pwede naman na huwag niyo ipapakita yung password niyo sa iba. Okay, so... Okay. Okay, so yun na yan. Next. Okay, sabi niya kulang pa. Okay. Tingnan natin. Next natin. So wala namang wala namang tao ngayon na hindi nakakaalam kung paano gumawa ng email. Ito, palitan ko. 0977105-8353. Okay, so ngayon, ngayon pipermahan na ni Bongbong Marcos yung registration ng ating phone number. Okay, so maging maingat sa paglalagay ng phone number nyo. Okay, kasi nga i-re-register na natin yan ngayon sa NTC or sa mga sa Globe. Pwedeng sa Smart, hindi natin alam kung ano yung implementing rules and regulation. Basta be careful of your email na hindi magamit ng iba. Kasi pag ginamit ng iba yan, mag-a-appear yung number nyo, pwede kayong kasuhan ng gobyerno. Pwede kayong mahuli, okay? So, yung cellphone din natin, ingatan natin kung mawala. I-report ka agad. So, okay, next. Next natin. Okay. So, siyempre, nag-appear yun doon sa aking phone. So wala kasi akong dalang SIM ngayon, nag-appear yun doon sa phone ko sa bahay. So bine-verify doon yung phone number ko. Okay, so balikan na natin. Hindi kasi may input kasi wala akong dalang SIM card ngayon. Okay, so lahat naman tayo alam kung paano gumawa. So ang gagawin lang natin na nadagdag lang sa pictures nito ay yung .cbpa. Okay, ilalagay niyo yung pangalan niyo. .cbpa uniform tayo. Okay, wag kayong mag-extension ng ibang extension dito kundi .cbpa. Okay, kasi sa CBPA natin gagamitin. Exclusively for CBPA student only. Hindi natin kailangan gamitin yung dati nating account na ginagamit natin sa pakikipag-chat sa iba or yung dati na nag-i-exist. So, kailangan may private tayo para sa CBPA. Okay, pag ni-next-next natin yan, katulad ng normal na procedure ng paggawa ng email, yan lang naman yung nadagdag kasi kailangan uniform tayo. Malinaw ba? Malinaw. Okay, so kung malinaw sa lahat, pwede naman kasi talaga tayong mag-add dyan ng pictures natin. Alam naman natin kung paano i-add yung pictures kasi yung photos, I'm talking about the photos. Okay, lalagyan natin ng photo yan kasi yun yung mag-a-appear sa ating Google Classroom, yung email na yan. So hindi ko na ididire-direcho kasi inihold eh. Wala akong dala kasi ngayon na SIM card. Anyway, pag nag-add tayo ng picture yan sa ating email, hindi pwede yung nakapambahay yung picture natin. Kailangan presentable. Okay, so presentable yung picture na ilalagay sa ating email, lalo na doon sa mga first year na nakikinig ngayon. Hindi pwede yung para ka magdadive sa swimming pool. Ibig sabihin, may pagka parang magsiswimming yung suot. Hindi pwedeng ganun. Hindi pwedeng naka-bathing suit, hindi pwedeng naka-as-in, hindi rin pwedeng nakapantulog. Okay, hindi rin yung katulad ng mga nakikita ko dati sa mga first year na pinakikita pa yung six-pack abs nila. Yung parang nag-gym. Okay, hindi pwede yung ganung pictures na i-add natin sa ating email. Bukod sa uniform tayo dito, pangalan nyo, and then yung extension na CBPA, yun yung gagawin natin sa paggawa natin ng email. Okay? So, ano pa yung mga ino-observe? Okay, sa email, bawal rin yung pictures na cartoons. Okay, yung mga animation. Ginagawa nating animation, yung pictures natin. Okay, so may pictures kasi na ganyan ngayon. Sa cellphone, yung nilalagyan ng balbas dito. Okay, lahat ng edited. Okay, hindi for fun kasi to. Ito ay for study. Okay, part kasi ng ating pag-aaral yung ethical standard. So, bukod sa hindi pwede ang malaswa na pictures, lalo na yung gagamit din kayo ng pictures ng ibang tao or ibang name yung gagamitin. Okay, so konti lang naman yung idinagdag natin. Hindi na tayo i-elaborate natin masyado yung email kasi yung generation natin, alam na natin yung tungkol sa email. Sabi ko nga, bakit pa i-describe natin yung email, i-alam na ng lahat yan. So sabi ni Sir Willie, kasi may standard tayo na ginagamit na pangalan. Yun nga yung name nyo and then yung CBPA. So halos kompleto na ang alam natin. Yun nga lang, ito yung kulang. Dapat ganito. Sa katotohang pangalan nyo ilalagay. Huwag yung mga aliases, okay? Yung mga alias, Okay, huwag ilalagay yun. Huwag ding ilalagay kung ano-anong pangalan. Pangalan ng artista yung ilalagay. So, hindi pwede yun. Kailangan talaga personalize, okay, yung name nyo. Okay, kasi nga, hindi kayo i-honor. Baka i-block pa kayo doon sa Google Classroom. Okay? Huwag na huwag nyo ding ipapasa yung Google code, Google Classroom code sa mga kaibigan nyo or sa kapatid nyo or kahit kanino. Mga iba, tinatamad-matin ng klase, ipapasa na lang yung para lang ma-in sila sa klase, ipapasa sa iba. So pag nalaman ng iba yan, tandaan nyo, mahuhuli at mahuhuli kayo kasi naka-record na ngayon yung ating Google Classroom. Okay, connected kasi sa email yan. So pag gumawa ka ng bogus na email, pagkatapos ibinigay nyo yung code, pinagkalat nyo yung code natin, okay, permanent kasi yung code natin, may possibility na mahuli kayo kasi nakatag tayo sa server. Okay, meron tayong Google Drive, meron ding records, maraming protection to. And then expected din na baka sakali in a worst case scenario may gumawa nun, eh may ipahuli ka agad. Okay, so yun yung ating email. Napaka sagrado ng email natin na gagamitin natin sa school. So ganyan yung paggawa ng email. Okay, may .cbpa. Okay, so at gmail.com. Huwag nyo nang dadagdagan ng kung ano-anong number. Basta yung extension, ganyan. Kung may kapangalan ka dito, pwede ka naman magdagdag rito kung may kapangalan. Yung hindi talaga makapasok kasi may kapangalan. Minsan ganun eh. Hindi makapasok. Dahil katulad ng pangalan. May estudyante ako, parehong-pareho ng pangalan eh. Middle initial lang yung pinagkaiba. So, yun, pwede kayo magdagdag ng letters dito. Pero dapat ipilyedo nyo pa rin at pangalan nyo. Okay? Doon, middle initial. Kunwari, ilagay ko rito yung M. So, pwedeng ganyan. reyesjoelm.cbpa okay, at gmail.com. Okay? So, lagyan nyo ng maganda password. And then, sabi ko nga, huwag mag-a-add ng picture na hindi decent, na hindi naka-corporate attire. Kailangan naka-corporate attire tayo sa mga first year na nakikinig dyan. And then, kalimutan na natin yung ugali natin nung K-12. Okay? Walang magdadala sa college ng ugali nila ng K-12. Why? Kasi yung K-12, yun pa yung ugaling bata. Wala pa tayo sa maturity nun. So, ngayon, nandito na tayo sa stage of maturity, the stage of reality, which is the college course. Okay, candidate for degree kayo pagka-graduate nito. So, college degree na kayo pag-graduate nito, pero hindi kayo makakalusot kung kayo magbabiolate ng rules ng IRIS. I'm talking about the email. So, pag tayo kasi naka-enroll, pasok tayo doon sa breach of contract. Ibig sabihin, naka-contract tayo rito, nagagawa tayo ng kabutihan. Okay? So, hindi natin ino-honor yung paggawa ng kung ano-anong email. So, ganyan lang yung pwede natin gawing email. And then, pag ni-next mo yan, hindi kasi ako nakagawa ng dami kasi naka-live ako ngayon. So, pag ni-next mo yan, naglagay ka ng password, papasok na yung password doon. And then, katulad ng normal na email, may nakalagay doon dito sa gilid nito, join meeting. And then, doon ka makaka-join sa meeting ng ating Google Classroom. Okay, the other question is yung code. Paano kukunin yung code sa professor para makapuasok sa Google Classroom? I-email yun ng Dean's Office, padadala yun sa inyo. Okay, so yun yung ating paggawa ng email. Dito lang naman nagkaiba. Okay. In the rest, katulad na rin yung ginagawa nating email, yung ating ginagawang email before. Basta ito ay hindi pwedeng gamitin sa ibang transaction. Okay, gagamitin nyo ito for educational purpose only. Okay, iba yung ginagamit yung private. So, yun lang yung masasabi ko. Pag mag-a-add ng pictures, huwag malaswa. Huwag parang dadive sa swimming pool. Inuulit ko. Huwag yung magpapakita ng malaking abs. Pakikita pa roon na edited yung abs niya. Pinakita roon. Basta hindi decenting pictures or photos, hindi natin tinotolerate yan. Hindi rin pwedeng maglagay ng cartoons na animation, yung paborito yung cartoons yun na ilalagay nyo. Kunwari si Bugs Bunny yung inilagay nyo, hindi ino-honor natin yung dito sa IRIS. Okay? So yun yung mga ethical standards sa paggawa ng email. Okay? And the rest, familiar naman kayo dyan. Ngayon, kung hindi kayo familiar, pwede nyo kaming i-message dito. Tutulungan namin kayong gumawa. Okay? Para doon sa hindi familiar. Pero sa generation natin ngayon, majority familiar. Okay? So anyway, ganun lang yun. Paggawa natin ng email account. Okay? God bless to all. Okay. So, tapos na ako ng pag-present.
All right. So, thank you so much, Sir Brill, and for sharing that important information. Ay, Sir Brill,
si Joel,
Sir Joel, I'm so sorry.
Tatampo na si Sir Joel sa'yo.
Huwag ka magtatampo, Sir Joel. Thank you so much, Sir Joel. And syempre, napaka-importante na i-share ni Sir Joel itong didiscuss niya itong about sa pag-create ng account, lalo na sa mga new incoming fresh student na mga first year college na malalaman nila kung ano bang dapat nilang i-follow, kung ano bang dapat ilagay nilang picture, at kung ano ba dapat ang ilalagay nilang account name sa Google account na igagawin nila. So before we jump again to another part of the program, let's have another intermission number again from the town.
Partner, mukhang mag-iya tayo naman. So, next muna natin is si Sir Brill. Ay, may tanong okay. po pala, Sir okay, Joel. May nagtanong po sa ating Zoom.
Yes?
Maaari daw po bang gamitin ang graduation picture sa email picture?
Ano yun, anak? Graduation? May sounds kasi, hindi ko madinig. May sounds kasi.
Graduation picture daw po, Sir Joel. Sa may
pwede.
Zoom.
Pwede anak, pwede. Basta disente. Basta naka-corporate naman tayo sa graduation picture, pwede yun. Basta wag lang malaswa. So binabawal natin yung, siyempre tayo may mga iba-ibang culture tayo. Pero kasi dito standard tayo. Dapat nasa business tayo, naka-corporate. Pero yung sa graduation, pwede yun. Okay, hindi bawal yun. Basta wag lang nakapambahay or malaswa yung picture. Okay? So, hindi natin ina-allow dyan. Standard tayo sa corporate, sa graduation, pwede.
Okay, thank you, Sir Joel. So, next naman natin is the asynchronous learning, uploading of instructional materials. And now, let's move forward to, can I call on Professor Andre Christian Burriel.
Okay, good afternoon. Tech team, can I share my screen? Okay, can you see my screen?
Yes, po, sir.
So, this is just a review of ayan, so a review of on how to post instruction materials. This is intended actually for our faculty members. So, this is an example of one of my classrooms. Okay. So if you would notice, I'm on the stream page. So this is where we can talk to our class, share announcements, post assignments, and respond to student questions. So to post a content, okay, so we go to classwork, then we click on create. Okay. It would be best to use material, because if we use material, we can assign a topic and then a title. So in this case, I will make use of our VMGO as an example. Okay. So we type in here VMGO, okay. And then our title would be we'll just use the option paste. So paste. And then on the description box, we post the body of the message. Wait now. Okay. Then we click on post. Okay, so if you've noticed already uploaded one content under topic VMGO, the title will be the vision, mission, goals, and objectives. Tapos if you click this part, you'd be able to see the ERIS vision and mission, the college goals, and the objectives of the program. Okay. So our next example, if we want to upload a document, so yung first example, kasi we just posted a content. Okay. This time, we're going to upload a document. So same process, we click on create, use the option material. This time, our topic would be about uploading of the syllabus. Click on just paste. So here we have the option to retrieve the file or the document either through your drive, or if it's an online source, we can upload it here, click on this icon, or through a link. But in this case, the syllabus is already saved in my drive. So we'll just click on this, the G Drive icon. We select the file, add, and then post. Okay. So if you've noticed, I've already created two topics. The second one is syllabus, title is organization and management. And then if you click on, you can view the material. So to all our freshman students, you can view the core syllabus of organization and management. Okay. So I'll just scroll down. Okay, so that's it. And then for our third example, and then if you've noticed, on the stream page, every time we post something under classwork, meron siyang corresponding notification so that our students are informed of any activity that we did. So our last example would be how to create an assignment. So same process, we click on create, choose assignment. Under assignment, we can set a deadline, okay, including the date and time. Okay, and then you create a topic, post a title, and then post the body of the message or attach a file from Drive. We can even include the rubrics and tick the box, check plagiarism to check on the originality of the submitted classwork of the students. Okay. So going back sa classwork, we can even sort or organize this page. For example, we want the syllabus to be placed under VMGO. So we just click on these three vertical lines and move down. So if they would visit our classwork, they would see here that the first topic would be VMGO or syllabus. Or you can just simply drag the topic. So just click on, yan po, or vice versa. Okay, wait. Ayan. So ganyan po siya. Okay. So that's the end of my presentation. Thank you.
All right. So thank you so much, Sir Viril, for sharing that important instruction. So, partner?
Yes, partner. And ano ba next natin dito?
Yeah. So next naman natin, before we jump again to another part of the program, so let's have another information number again from the talented committees. So let's give a big round of applause.
Excited ka na ba sa another intermission number natin, partner?
Yes naman, inaabangan ko kung sino yan eh. Nang masipat natin sa face-to-face.
Hahanapin mo ba? Grabe ka naman.
Susulok, hahanapin natin kasulok-sulokan ng school. Lalo na yung mga nag-talent na yan.
Grabe ka naman. Hindi lang pala crush ang hinahunting.
Marami tayong hunting inside school.
So may idea ka na ba, partner, kung sino yung mag-i-an natin, intermission number?
Ah, hindi ko rin alam, partner eh. Siguro yung kaklase ko yan. Ay, joke na.
Ay, joke. Maybe yung kaklase ko pala nag-intermission number. Hindi kaya natin pasakot naka... saan.
Shoutout nga pala sa aming president. Alright.
Saan nagsimulang magbago ang lahat? Kailan nung ako'y di na naging sapat? Ba't di mo sinabi nung una pa lang ako ang kailangan? Pero saan nakulang ang aking pagmamahal? Lahat ay binigay ng mapangiti ka lang. Ba't ko nakita na ayaw mo na? Ako ang kasama, pero hanap mo siya. Sa piling niya, hindi ko napipilit pa. Ang tanging iling ko lang sa kanya, huwag kang paluhain at alaga. Saan natigil ang pagiging totoo? Sa tuwing mababanggit na mahal mo ako, ba't di mo inamin na merong iba? Ako ang kayakap, pero sa piling niya, hindi ko napipilit pa.
Grabe, partner, palamig ng palamig talaga.
Di ko ba alam kung saan na tayo mapupunta?
Sabi dito sa YouTube, ang daming nagko-comment sa YouTube. Sabi, ang ganda ng boses mo po, sabi ni Delugar, John Kenneth J.
Siguro nalalamig na talaga.
Tapos every bill daw, grabe naman talaga.
Sabi naman yan. Alright, so let's proceed. Thank you for that beautiful, wonderful intermission number. So to discuss a synchronous class face-to-face, let's call ahead for Dr. Hernan Oliveros.
Download your meditation videos and unwind uninterrupted. Try our student plan.
Another line of teaching methodology, which is I request often now. Every week is passion week for me. Ayan, thank you so much. I am Dr. Hernan Oliveros. I am one of the faculty of Human Resource Management under the supervisions of Dr. Shaleen U. Escario. I was assigned to handle one of the teaching methodologies, which is synchronous. But on the setup of... Why you keep... Okay, our lesson, as you observed later or a while ago, Professor Christian Biriel discussed other form of methodologies, which is asynchronous. So our focus for this, for my presentation, is more on online discussion. My subject is Fundamentals of Accounting under Trading and Service Industry. So may I request to the facilitator to share my video presentation. Thank you so much.
Good morning, everyone. I am so much happy to discuss with you your module one, that is the nature of businesses. I hope you're doing good and you're doing fine. And always believe to the powers of prayers that everything happens for a reason and God bless you. What will be the nature of businesses under your module one? But before we proceed to the nature of businesses, let us first discuss the intended learning outcome. By the end of the module, the students are expected to understand the importance of accounting in business and how it applies. Ayan. Define what are the characteristics of business. Analyze the different kinds of business according to ownership and operation, and how the decision-making varies depending on their business. Okay. The best example of the nature of businesses is one of the business tycoon in the Philippines. So the name of that business tycoon is Henry, the late Henry. According to Henry, he started with shoes and with hard work and discipline, the business prospered. Actually, class, Henry C. was started during so much time. So he started as a shoemaker, and look at now the SM, group of companies. That is the success story of Henry C. We all know how Henry C. is one of the richest tycoon in the Philippines. However, not all people know what happened before all these achievements came into his life. The story, or the success story of Henry, will give us a better and positive perspective on how we're able to manage our business. And now, the SM of group of companies are managed by the heirs of Henry and Gen Z BDO, and Gen Z SM Hypermarket, and Gen Z China Bank, and Gen Z SMDC, and so one of the SM Holdings, and so madami pang company na naging legacy ni Henry. Okay. So let us now proceed. I want you to read the success story of Henry. So that will be the link or the reference of that success history of Henry. Sabi niya, with his inspiring story, one can learn about the ideals of success. Henry C. tells us not to give up on our dreams, no matter how far-fetched or fetched it seems. Who knows, maybe yours is the next success story to tell. So despite of this pandemic, this is not the reason for us to stop, but rather this is the reason for us to proceed and to start a new beginning, right? So let us continue. Let us define what is business. And business, according to a well-known professor, William Bright, Robert Hatches, and Jack Copper, business is the organized effort of individuals to produce and sell for a profit the goods and services that satisfy society's needs. In a more brief definition, according to Urwich and Hunt, business is any enterprise which makes, distributes, or provides any services which one other members of the community need and are willing to pay it. Remember, class, in establishing our business, we must have an idea. Then that idea, we will put that into reality. We need a better understanding about what we're doing. We need to know the nature of our businesses so that we will know when to start and how to start with. Kailangan meron tayong puso. Kailangan meron tayong magandang simula patungkol sa ating negosyo. Kasi ngayon, kailangan ang mga bata, katulad nyo, ay merong magandang pananaw sa pagnenegosyo. Hindi dapat tayo tumanda na bilang isang empleyado. It is an encouragement to everyone to have our own business and to start with our own business, even a small one, a small capital that can be a good and big and huge capital in the future. Who knows na maging katulad din tayo ni Hendesy, okay? Katulad ni Gokong Wei, that is the empire of Robinson, di ba? Katulad ni Lu Xutan, katulad ni San Miguel Corporations, Petron, at iba't ibang malalaking kumpanya dito sa Pilipinas. So lalayo pa pa tayo kay Jollibee Food Corporations. Yeah. So nandyan ang Chowking, na kung saan it talks about the selling of goods, okay? That is abundant, okay? A value meal. And McDonald's, selling of Mac Burger, and French fries, and Greenwich, and selling of pizza. The five characteristics of business, production, or acquisition of goods. Simple class, bago tayo makagawa ng isang pizza, para tayo makagawa ng isang value meal, kailangan mo muna na mag-acquire ng goods from the production or acquisition of goods. And then, profit, the basic motive of business. Wala naman sigurong business na gustong magtayo para malugi, unless otherwise, ang business mo ay social-oriented. Sabihin, ang main naka-purpose mo is to help others or to provide social justice. Okay, that is for now. Risk, uncertainty of future, especially nowadays. Madami mga negosyante ang nalulugi. Marami negosyante ang gusto nilang i-maintain yung kanilang sustainability. Pero wala silang magawa because of the community or general community. Okay, quarantine. So may mga pagkakataon, nakakasimula pa lang nilang mag-umpisa, ito magsasara na naman sila. Dealing in goods and services. Okay, dapat ma-maintain nila yung loyalty ng mga customer nila. Ma-maintain nila yung mga customer nila na tuloy-tuloy at patuloy na pinapatronate ang kanilang produkto. Regular dealings from time to time, di ba? Kailangan nilang maayos yung kanilang internal policies. Kailangan nilang maayos yung kanilang relationship internally and also relationship external. Okay? Let us proceed to the kinds of business according to ownership. Single or sole proprietorship, na kung saan isa lamang ang nagmamay-ari. Ang isang sole or single proprietorship ay nire-register sa Department of Trade and Industry. And partnership, that is under Article 1767, two or more persons combine themselves, their property, their ideas or industry, their money, okay, para magtayo ng isang kumpanya. Ang tawag po dyan ay partnership. Sa mata ng batas, maraming iba't ibang uri ng partnership. Nandito ang general professional partnership na kung saan ang mga the same profession ay nagsama-sama. For example, doctors, lawyers, nagtayo ng isang company at ang tawag po doon ay general professional partnership. Meron naman tinatawag na other partnership na kung saan kahit sino pwedeng magsama. Katulad ng for example, isang farmers nakipagkasundo sa isang architect, isang architect nakipagkasundo sa isang engineer, isang engineer nakipagkasundo sa isang accountant. So ang tawag po doon ay other partnership. Okay, basta tatandaan natin pag partnership, two or more persons combine themselves, their property, their money, or their industry. Corporation under Republic Act 11232, amending Corporation Code of the Philippines. Dati, ang corporation ay minimum of 5, no? 5 and maximum of 15. With that respect, under RA 11232, ang isang tao ay pwede nang magtayo ng isang korporasyon. Ang tawag po doon ay sole corporation. Okay, cooperative under RA 11354 as amending provisions for Philippine Cooperative Code of 2008. Ano ba ang pagkakaiba nilang dalawa maliban as to the number of owner, as to the number of partners, as to the number of incorporators, or as to the number of members? Ang pagkakaiba nila ay of course yung kanilang purpose. Okay? Ang kanilang operating cycle. Kung paano ba tumatakbo ang kanilang business mula sa acquisition or production, papunta sa profit orientation, papunta on how to manage the risk or how to expect those uncertainties, the dealings with goods and services, and dealings with the regular dealings from time to time. Okay? Do you have any questions so far? Okay, thank you so much. We will now proceed to other topic. Okay, kind of business according to operation, service concern. Katulad ng isang pet shop, katulad ng isang barber shop. Kung napapansin ninyo, ang binibenta po dito ay service. Okay? Sa pet shop, posibleng magbenta din sila ng pet. Okay? Pero depende kung ano ang primary purpose ng company nila. Okay, thank you so much. That's how we conduct with our online discussions. And of course, with the next presenter, Professor Eric Monte will discuss other venues or platform for our assessment tool. Thank you so much and welcome to the College of Business and Public Administration.
Thank you, Dr. Hernan Oliveros, for discussing the synchronous class. So let's move forward to online assessment tools. Can I call on Professor Eric Monte? So partner, habang hinihintay natin si ano si Sir Professor Eric Monte. Ano bang mga comments natin sa live chat ngayon?
Hintay din ako ng live chat. Ibahin natin partner in question. Kung ikaw pagbibigyan ka ng isang pagkakataon para magkaroon ng sarap. Ayun na pala.
Mamaya na natin ituloy ang chismis.
Okay.
A blessed morning to all of us. We welcome you all to the new academic year and hope you all will excel in all the subjects and the curriculum. Make us proud with your best efforts and results. So I'm going to discuss the different online assessment tools in our synchronous online classes. So online assessment tools for some concepts and definitions is typically includes tests, quizzes, and questionnaires that teachers can administer to students so that they can examine their progress in different learning areas. For example, they can include skill assessment, communication tests, and behavioral evaluations. It allows professors to create tests based on curriculum content or learning development needs. It tracks student data for future reports, allowing them to create more targeted educational practices. So the teachers may use these platforms to gauge students' personality and response to a classroom environment. Second is to evaluate a student's current skills, abilities, and knowledge. And last is to showcase students' progress. So the following are the list of assessment tools used for tracking student progress. No? So number one, ang ginagamit natin dito sa ating school is the Google Forms. Now Google Forms is a go-to among teachers because it's quick and simple to create and automatically grade quizzes and other task activities na ibibigay sa inyo ng inyong mga subject professors. No? Since we are using a Google Classroom as our learning management system sa ating online classes, no? Although for the whole month of October, online classes tayo, and professors can maximize the use of Google Forms, no, in giving your assignments and task activities, no. Although pagdating ng November ay full face-to-face na tayo, yung mga subject professors niyo ay pwede pa rin gumamit ng Google Classroom, Google Forms to submit a soft copy of your activities task na ibibigay po sa inyo, no. So usually sa college natin, we are having our two activities, yung ating written works and performance tasks based to the course learning outcomes na ipapaliwanag or explain sa inyo ng mga subject professors ninyo sa mga different course syllabus na i-share sa inyo sa start ng inyong mga respective classes. So the second assessment tools na ginagamit ng mga subject professors natin dito sa ating college is the yung mentimeter, no? Mentimeter it comes with the preloaded with education templates, no? For the classrooms or Google Classrooms, like listening skills assessment, gumagamit din, meron din mga icebreakers, formative assessment, post lecture surveys, and polls, no. So sometimes during the class, no, or tawag dito lectures, no, some of the professors maximize the use of this kind of assessment tool, no, itong mentimeter. Okay, so the third one na ginagamit din ng mga ibang subject professors is the Kahoot, no? It is a game-based approach to learning and assessment, no. So some of the professors can choose from more than 40 million ready to go learning games, or they can create their own in minutes, no. They can host games lives, or as they can give us an assignment for them, no. So next is the na ginagamit namin, or some of the professors that use it, the quizzes, no. It is a learning platform that offers multiple tools, no, to make a classroom or online class fun, interactive, and engaging, no? And some of the professors, no, can create their lessons or conduct formative assessment, assign homeworks, and have other interactions with the students in a captivating way. So those are only some of the examples na ginagamit namin. There are also, nasa prerogative na lang ng mga ibang subject professors nyo kung ano pa yung mga different assessment tools or online assessment tools na pwede nilang gamitin sa inyong mga respective classes, no? So for my last quote, always have faith in your ability. Success will comes your way eventually. Best wishes for a successful and flourishing future. Thank you, and God bless us all. Good luck, everyone.
So thank you, Professor Eric Mante, and to the other speaker for the knowledgeable lesson. So, partner, buhay pa ba ang ating mga YouTube viewers natin ngayon?
Yes naman. Yes naman, yung pwede naman kayong kumain habang nakikinig, at syempre huwag natin kalimutan na pusuan na ating mga comment section.
Grabe, nahinga pa daw sabi sa ating Zoom, sabi ni MM1B.
Hinga-hinga lang.
Mayra. Grabe ah, nahinga pa. Kumain na ba ang lahat? Ikaw ba, partner? Kumain ka na ba, partner?
Unti-unti lang, partner. Hindi naman lahatan.
Grabe yan. So, sa ating mga viewers sa YouTube, don't forget to use our official hashtag for today. Hashtag CBPA, hashtag here is CBPA, and hashtag step in, stand out, stop, start up.
All right. So for the last game, partner, I would like to ask everyone to participate in our third icebreaker.
Grabe, icebreaker na naman.
Yes, partner.
Ano nga ba yung icebreaker natin for today?
ang ating icebreaker is, alam ko, alam na alam mo to, partner. Ito ay, one word, syempre, four picks, one word, magaling ka dito.
Ay nako, nilalaro yan ng mga ano, magulang ko.
Lagi.
So, ganun din, we prepared another three questions for you to answer and all you need to do is type the right answer on the chat box.
At syempre, yung mga nanonood dyan, huwag natin kalimutan na mag-comment at ilagay ang tamang sagot. So, let's go ahead.
Okay, number one natin. Asa na ang ating number one? Ayun, number one natin. May clue pala ba, partner?
Nako, ano yan? Ano ba yan? Ang hirap ng partner.
Wala din ako idea.
Ang hirap. Alright, time's up. So ano nga ba ang tamang sagot?
Mission.
Mission. Wow, ang galing ni Kyla is Topito. Nakuha niya ang mission. At ang mission mo ay makinig sa discussion. Alright, next.
Grabe naman yun. Number two natin.
Okay, para mabuhay ang ating class. Mm-hmm. Ang kulay naman yan, partner.
Ano kaya yan? Rainbow.
Ay. Ano kaya yan? Ang professor natin ah. Ay, hindi. Aba. Time's up. Wow, creative. Congratulations. Ang galing naman ni Almira. Almira, kailan mo maging creative? Next?
Siyempre, kailangan sa buhay.
Mm-hmm. Nako, depressed na ata to.
Ay, grabe naman. Pahirap ng pahirap.
Pahirap ng pahirap.
Time's up! Hardship.
Hardship. Wow. By the way, thank
Siyempre,
you dun na.
Siyempre, yung hardship, hindi may iwasan yan sa buhay.
As always, lagi. Lalo na sa pag-aaral.
So, okay, thank you.
I hope everyone enjoy our third icebreaker. Go ahead, partners.
So, dahil dyan, excited ka na ba? Another intermission number tayo.
Another intermission na naman. Another na naman na tao na hanapin.
Another na malamig na naman.
Alamig sa tanghaling tapat.
So, you are, right. Are you excited to have an intermission number again? If you do, of course, I am also excited. Let's give them a virtual round of applause.
You don't know, babe. It's the sunrise and those brown eyes. You're the one that I desire. When we wake up and then we make love, it makes me feel so nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the Tylenol I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine on my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow, no matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, best part.
If you love me, won't you say something?
If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you?
Grabe. Kailan bang hindi lalamig ang ano?
Grabe. Ang sweet naman. By the way, shout out kay Heart Binico sa kaklasiko. Siya nga palang kumanta noon.
Shout out din sa Team Dishwasher na nanonood.
Wow. Grabe, partner. Go ahead, partner.
So, thank you. Let's give them a big round of applause again. For the one of the talented committees, ang gagaling nyo, nakaka-proud. So, the next part of the program is for the CBPA declaration oath. May I request to call the CSG Governor, Mr. Renz Guillier Villano, and to be followed by the response from the student. So habang hinihintay pa ang declaration oath natin by the CBPASD governor, may mga nagpapa-shoutout sa ating YouTube live. Sabi ni Trisha Liprea, shoutout sa BSE1A.
Sino po dyan mga partner?
Tapos sabi din ni Vice Governor, shout out po kay Ejong. So,
ayan na.
Balik na tayo ulit.
Good day, CBPAans. Here is your governor to do the outtaking for the CBPA declaration oath. Mr. Renz Guillier Villano. We, the students of CBPA, mind ourselves with the cooperate for the attainment of the IRIS vision, mission, goals, and objectives. We speak that we extend more and we choose student direction as that our school want to reach. We return our back for uncooperative attitude in the past and start to our give best to fulfill our duties and responsibilities. We declare that we are one with the CBPA faculty, one heart, one voice, and one mission.
So habang inihintay natin yung isa pa, the respond from the student. May nagpapa-shoutout din ba sa'yo, partner?
Ako, partner, di ko makita dito. Ang dami nung papa-shoutout. Kasi ang dami nilang comment and chat.
Ayun.
Good afternoon po.
Good afternoon din po. So, habang hinihintay natin, sabi dito sa ating Zoom viewers, pa-shoutout daw kay OWASP PRO1 Kimberly.
Kimberly, kumain ka na ba?
O ba, partner, kumain ka na ba?
Siyempre, hindi pa.
Or diet tayo.
Or diet tayo. Hintay natin matapos ito, partner. Especially yung mga nanonood, huwag kayo agad aalis.
So, next na tayo, presentation of student organization. And today, we would like to bid a warm introduction of our college organization.
So okay, can you hear me?
Yes, woman.
Bakit ako naka-mute? Narinig kita. Volume.
Yes, Bomam Divina.
Yes. Asan ako?
So habang hinihintay natin yung video for the presentation of the CBO, shout out daw sa BSOA 3C, pati sa mga MCs. Shout out.
Wow. Shout out sa inyo.
Sino ko ba? Pa-shout out daw sa may utang sa akin, sabi ni Virtus John Marquez. Grabe naman yung pati utang kung maabot sa ating YouTube live.
Bayad-bayad din.
Sino po ba? Shoutout daw po kay Irish ng BSE1A. Hi daw po, sabi ng isang student ng BSE1. Grabe!
Pa-shoutout din pala din kay sa mga friend ko sa 1B, Maypa Graham. Wow, Maypa Graham talaga. Si John Penitez. Patines.
Sabi naman ni Nerlin Yadaw, shoutout po sa MM1A, mga hindi pa po sila naliligo. Ay, grabe yan.
Grabe naman yan.
Hindi naliligo.
Mamaya magbabad kayo sa yelo.
Same ako niyan.
So, as na ating video. So, may pahabol. Shout out po sa MM2C at sa magandang Vice Mayor. Shout out! Wala ka na ba nakita dyan ng mga nagpapa-shout out? Habang hinihintay natin ang ating video.
Wala pa, partner eh. Pero ano bang masishare mo since graduating ka na? Ano bang masishare mo sa ating mga fresh student na papasok?
Ako, halo-halo ang aking mga naging experience.
Huwag din bad experience.
May masaya, malungkot, may nakakagalit.
Yung masaya na lang para ma-encourage naman ating mga fresh student.
Yung masaya, madami. Naranasan ko dati nung F2F is ano, tawag dito, madaming mga events.
Sana maka-join din.
Contest ng mga iba't ibang colleges, naranasan ko yun.
Halo-halo mga estudyante. Ayan na.
Ayan na ang ating week ng ano. Back to the exciting part. Thank you.
CBPA Student Government is a group of students in charge of a variety of school-related events, activities, programs, policies, and initiatives. Members who provide the highest levels of leadership are elected by the student's body, just as they are in other forms of government. The CBPSG constitute media advisor and the officers. The officers governor, Mr. Renz Guillier Arbiliano. Vice governor, Mr. Arenio Alcelamea. Secretary, Ms. Catherine Joy A. Balao. Treasurer, Jillian Nicole S. Garcilla. Auditor, Ms. Kimberly S. Salvador. And the representatives are Joylyn Amparo, Kenneth Yutatpo, SDM Asuncion. And here is the achievements of the CBPA-SG this academic year 2021 to 2022.
Ayun, grabe naman yun. Alam ko may isa pang video eh.
O nga partner, asa na nga ba yun?
Natago ata sa ano. So habang hinihintay natin, shout out muna tayo.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ni Kent Marion Pascua, ate ba't ang ganda mo po? Sino po sa aming dalawa? Dalawa po kami maganda.
Ayan na.
Ayan na.
Arthur.
Teacher's Day is a special day to thank and remember the teachers who have shaped us and show our appreciation for them. As we celebrate Teacher's Day, we honor teachers like you. I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone, especially the CBPA professors. Thank you for making our classes so enjoyable. Happy Teacher's Day to every teachers out there, especially to someone who always gave her 100%. Happy Teacher's Day, Naichanda. Your knowledge, dedication, and concern will always guide us in the right direction. I and my co-officer are grateful to have someone like you. Thank you for always guiding us. Don't stress yourself too much and always smile. We're here if you need backups. Always take care. I know that words are not enough, but we're here for you. You only deserve the best. Again, happy Teacher's Day.
This month, we celebrate National Teachers' Day as part of our gratitude to our teachers who support our growth in school and have been a part of our lives as second parents. To our mother, mom, professor, and CSG advisor, Dr. Chanda Artinga, happy Teachers' Day. Thank you very much for the advice, teasing, and teaching me about the other things within CSG. You are the real one who became my second parent in tahanan ni Amang. I just want to say thank you. And being strong in your jobs. One more year of bonding with you, ma'am. Happy Teacher's Day. Love, Vice Governor Zelameo.
Being a teacher and a professor is not easy enough. So I just want to greet all of the dearest Manila professors out there watching a happy, happy Teacher's Day. We appreciate all of your hard works and efforts to us students. Thank you. And also especially to our lovely dean, our college dean rather, Dr. Willie O. Gapasin. Happy, happy Teacher's Day. We appreciate your undying love and support when it comes to the events of CSG. We appreciate all of your efforts when it comes to teaching and for giving us some of your time to support us. Thank you also for the trust and support to the times of choosing me as one of your singers when it comes to the intermission number of the college. You really boost my confidence, which is I appreciate it the most. We, the officers, and I appreciate you. Thank you for everything. So I am Gila Nicole Argus Julia, the CBPA SG Treasurer. Happy, happy Teacher's Day to all!
Happy Teacher's Day to all professors, especially in our faculty, College of Business and Public Administration, and I especially mention to our college dean, Dr. Willie Ogapasin. Happy Teacher's Day to you, Dame, for your tireless support of our, to our college. CBPA SG is really grateful to have you as our college dean, and your leadership is unique. And for me, as the CBPA SG governor, all your sacrifices in college is endlessly appreciated. I'm rooting for all future events to be successful, especially this academic year. Again, happy Teacher's Day, Dr. Dean Willie Ogapasin. Have a great day, Dean.
All right, partner. Happy Teacher's Day.
Happy, happy Teacher's Day to all. So ayan na po, unod na natin ang pagbati ng mga student leaders para sa mga professors para sa Teacher's Day. Mukhang may sunod pa ata.
Meron pa nga, partner.
Greetings, Dr. Manalad. On behalf of Entrepreneurial Management Society, gusto ka po naming pasalamatan dahil hindi niyo po pinapabayaan ang EMS. Thank you for your service and efforts na ginagawa upang walang malagbihin na kahit sino mga student sa amin. Maraming salamat po and Happy Teacher's Day.
Happy Teacher's Day po, Ma'am Madagan. Thank you so much po sa lahat ng lessons na ibinahagi niyo po sa amin. And thank you so much po dahil naging isa po kayong magaling na professor. I hope na masaya po kayo ngayon. And again, thank you so much po and Happy Teacher's Day po ulit.
Happy Teacher's Day po, Dr. Melba Asuncion. So we just wanted to let you know that we appreciate everything you do for us. You are our inspiration, our motivation for us to pursue our dreams. Thank you so much and wishing you joy and happiness. God bless and Happy Teacher's Day po ulit.
Happy Teacher's Day, Ms. Anna. So ayun, thank you for continually inspire us to do our best and also to help us to strive for our goals in the future. Syempre, regarding to and related sa business na at course na kinukuha namin. So thank you for the knowledge that you shared with us. Yun yung masasabi natin, the world best teacher, ika nga, diba? So ayun, Happy Teacher's Day, Miss Anna!
Hi, Ma'am Gomez. Gusto ka po namin pasalamatan dahil sa pagiging supportive group and sa pagtuturo po sa amin is simple way at madaling maintindihan. Isa po kayo sa mga prof na nagpadali po ng aming college day. Thank you po and have a nice day. Happy Teacher's Day po!
Grabe yung pasabog ng EMS. Mukhang meron pa ata, partner.
Asa na ba yan? Ilabas na yan.
Susunod pa.
I'm really worried about your grades and your habitual tardiness.
I'm sorry po, ma'am. Hindi na po maulit.
May problema ba sa bahay?
Wala naman po.
Nandito lang ako pag kailangan mo ng kausap. Ako ang nanay mo sa school.
From Junior Marketing Society.
A professor with a big heart and a perfectionist in English proficiency. Thank you for being such a great teacher, Dr. David.
To the professor that cares for each individual student, thank you for your willingness to help us. We are so grateful, Ma'am Pagaling, for having you as our one of the best professors.
Hi, Sir Joel Reyes. Happy Teacher's Day. Thank you for guiding and teaching us. May God bless you always.
Thank you for being a wholesome person and for being a good and transparent advisor, especially to Junior Marketing Society. I just want to give a Happy Teacher's Day to our beloved, handsome advisor, Mr. Christian Andre Rudy.
Hi, Ma'am Kumpas! Happy Teacher's Day! Thank you for teaching us. Mabuhay ka hanggat gusto mo. Dito lang kami mga nagmamahal sa'yo. Thank you!
Greetings, Professor Jing Isla, the Marketing Management Students is greeting you a happy, happy Teacher's Day. We hope that you're always fine and we thank you for your righteousness and perseverance. Happy Teacher's Day po!
Namasan ang mga guro, minsan ay hindi pa tumunganga. Nagawang mangkina, pag-usay nag-ado ka. Talagang kahanga-hanga, kaya lang dito kami. Ang atin ng kawili-wili.
Tama nga ang ating mga guro. Sila ang ating mga panganawang magulang. Isa siya sa nagbibigay inspirasyon, motivation, at humuhubog sa aking kaalaman at kasanayan. Maging siya rin ay saksi sa mga panibagong kaalaman na aking nalalaman. Totoo nga na ang pagtuturo ay isang noble profession. Dahil hindi lang siya nagtrabaho para sa kanyang sarili, kundi maging para sa future ng bawat kabataan. Masaya siya kapag nakikita niya na natututo ang kanyang mga estudyante. Maliit man ang kanyang sweldo na kanyang natatanggap, hindi matatawaran ng anumang halaga ang karunungan na kanyang binibigay sa bawat mag-aaral. Ngayon, sa darating na araw ng mga guro, nais ko na siya'y pasalamatan, hindi lang dahil sa karunungan na kanyang ibinahagi sa akin, kundi sa kabutihan at mga motivasyon na isinabi niya sa akin. Happy Teacher's Day, Mom. Hiromi Kikuchi. We love you so much.
Who has always been amazing. Lectures were never boring when you were the one giving them. And learning is more fun when you have a professor who put his heart and soul into making each lecture a great learning experience. Happy Teacher's Day!
Inspiration to a lot of students po. And I think hindi po yun sapat, hindi po sapat ang sa inyong salamat para po matugunan namin ang inyong lahat ng tulong sa akin. Happy, happy Teacher's Day po ulit sa lahat. I hope na marami pa po kayong taong matulungan, like students po, like us. And maraming prosperous days po po sa pagpapalit. Yun lang po, sir, and again, a happy, happy Teacher's Day po.
Happy Teacher's Day po, Sir Jerome Paul Antonio. Thank you po, sir, and sana po i-grant po kayo ni God ng good health para po mapagpatuloy niyo po yung pagtuturo niyo and makapagturo pa po kayo ng matagal. Yun lang po, sir. Happy Teacher's Day po ulit. Ingat po kayo palagi and God bless!
Happy Teacher's Day po, Ms. Celestial. Sobrang nagpapasalamat po ang 2A na ngayon ay 3rd year na naging professor po namin kayo sa accounting. Sobrang naging madali po sa amin ng subject na yun dahil sa napakagaling na pong magturo. At considering po po kayo sa amin mga estudyante. Sana po ay maging healthy lang po kayo palagi. Nang sa kayo ay marami pa pong matutong mga estudyante po sa inyo. And God bless you po always. Happy Teacher's Day po ulit at stay safe po. Thank you.
Happy World Teacher's Day, Dr. Milas. Thank you for placing effort and dedication to your role as an educator. Your lessons and guidance that go beyond the classroom will remain with us in a lifetime. Happy Teacher's Day!
Hi, sir. How are you? Happy Teacher's Day. I wish you have a nice and happy Teacher's Day. Thank you for believing in the potential of each and every student. Your dedication, wisdom, and also your kindness will always lead us to the right way, and also to inspire us to be a better person. Once again, happy Teacher's Day po. God bless.
Good day po sa lahat ng mga professors sa Iris CBPA, especially to Sir Christian Miranda. Happy Teacher's Day po. I am so thankful that I was one of your students last school year, sir. As your student, we want to thank you for all of your wisdom, your guidance, and your discipline. I really appreciate your efforts, sir. And thank you so much for always motivating us. I know that you always want us to be the best version of ourselves, and I am so thankful for that, sir. Again, Happy Teacher's Day po. I hope na marami pa po kayong maturuan at ma-motivate ng mga students. Thank you and God bless po.
Hi, Professor Nolan Olivares. Thank you for making learning fun. Wishing you joy and happiness. You are an amazing professor and you only deserve the best. I am grateful to be your student. Happy Teacher's Day.
Annyeong! I just want to greet all of the teachers and professors a happy, happy Teacher's Day. Especially to our professor, Sir Isaac Ochotorena. Maraming salamat po sa knowledge at wisdom na binibigay niyo po para po kami ay matuto. Ganun na rin po ang paggabay at pag-inspire na hindi lamang po kami dapat matuto sa larangan ng academics, bagkus ganun din po sa pag-improve ng aming karakter para na rin sa aming future. Maraming salamat po sa pasensyang ibinibigay ninyo kahit na po makukulit at medyo sutil po kami mga estudyante. Maraming salamat po at patuloy niyo po sana kaming gabayan at turuan at huwag na huwag po kayong magsawa sa inyong profesyon. Yun lamang po, again, Happy Teacher's Day po, Sir Isaac Ochotorena. And saludo po ako sa inyo.
Happy Teacher's Day po sa lahat ng CBPA professor and especially to our area chair of the HRDF, Dr. Charlene Escario. Sobrang grateful po namin and blessed po namin, ma'am, na meron po kami isang area chair na talagang napakasipag at meron pong passion sa pagtatrabaho. Sobrang grateful and blessed din po namin dahil yung mga advices po ninyo ay talaga pong punong-puno po ng wisdom na madadala po namin hanggang sa work po namin kung sa mga future purpose po talaga. So, personally, nung time po na unang-una po ako nag-hosting, kayo po yung unang-una nag-advise sa akin patungkol sa hosting. So, nagpapasalamat po ako na mayroon pong isang Dr. Charlene Escario na magiging critic mo at magiging magkakaroon ka ng growth pag siya yung nakausap mo. So, sobrang nagpapasalamat po kami talaga na meron kami isang Dr. Charlene Escar na maaalalahanin at mapagmahal sa HRDM student. So, thank you ma'am sa walang sawang pagsuporta sa HRS and HRDM students. Enjoy your day and enjoy your month po. Happy Teacher's Day po, Dr. Charlene Escar, and sa lahat po ng CBPA professor.
A wonderful greetings to Professor Annalisa Asistol. As her second mother, I just wanted to say thank you for the patience, effort, and knowledge that you have shown and taught us. I wanted to greet you a happy Teacher's Day, and I do hope you enjoy your day.
Hi, Mom Mirelli Cruz. Happy Teacher Day po. I just want to say that you are truly an amazing teacher. We'll keep up to this now. All that thing. And wishing you more joy and happiness, and I'm deeply honored to get learn so many things from you. Happy Teacher's Day, po!
Happy Teacher's Day, Ma'am Angelita S. Lolo. No amount of words can properly express how much we appreciate the work you did in the teaching. Thank you, po.
Hello po, Ma'am Teresita. Happy Teacher's Day, po! Salamat po sa pagtuturo po sa amin and God bless po.
Happy Teacher's Day po, Ma'am Agida Cabreros. Ingat po palagi. Stay safe and God bless.
Happy Teacher's Day, Sir Marvin. Thank you for all the knowledge, patience, and especially the consideration that you gave us to us. Thank you so much, and again, we miss you, and Happy Teacher's Day. We love you, Sir Marvin.
Happy Teacher's Day, Ma'am Pilar. God bless po, lagi po kayo mag-iingat. Happy Teacher's Day po.
Happy Teacher's Day po, Dr. Rui Lawrence Reyes.
To Ma'am Sheila Castillo, I just want to give you a Happy Teacher's Day, Ma'am. Thank you for choosing to share your knowledge to us, and we really appreciate you. God bless you more po.
Happy Teacher's Day, Ma'am Flora. Thank you for all po, and God bless po. Happy Teacher's Day again, Ma'am.
A heartfelt thank you to Dr. Rosemary San Luis for spending her time, energy, and love to care to educate our section. Happy Teacher's Day, Ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you to all professors of CBPA. Happy Teacher's Day. We love them.
Happy Teacher's Day po, Ma'am Divina. So, I'm glad, Ma'am, na kayo po ay isa sa mga professor natin sa ating college. For me, Ma'am, even with just a short span of time, ay marami na po kami natutunan sa inyo. So, I'm glad na hanggang sa pagtapos ng college namin, ay makakasama namin kayo, Ma'am. And isa po ako, Ma'am, sa mga witness nyo, Ma'am, sa pagiging passionate at magaling yung pagtuturo, Ma'am. Since nakikita ko po kayo na nagtuturo kayo minsan sa office through online platform, and I saw you na sobrang passionate kayo, Ma'am. That's the thing na nainganyo, Ma'am, ako kung bakit gusto ko po na maging teacher niyo po kami one day, which is prof na po namin kayo in this incoming school year. And of course, naway marami pa po kayo maturuan ay estudyante with those and with all of your knowledge na maaari niyong ipasa sa amin sa mga pilang isang mag-aaral. I'm very thankful, Ma'am, na naging parte po kayo at magiging parte po kayo ng aming college life. At nawa, Ma'am, ay pagpalain kayo ng Panginoon at maging matatag kayo at malakas kayo lagi. Happy Teacher's Day again po, Ma'am. Bye-bye.
Hello po, Ma'am Dayan. Happy Teacher's Day po sa inyo. And hopefully, mas marami pa po kayong achievements na maabot sa taon na to. And congrats po sa mga achievements na natanggap nyo ngayong taon. Congratulations po ulit, Ma'am. And Happy Teacher's Day po. And I hope you have good health. And hopefully, mas makamit nyo po yung mga achievements and goals nyo for this year. And yun lang po, Ma'am. Happy Teacher's Day po ulit.
Grabe naman talaga ang mga pagbati para sa ating mga magaganda at gwapong guro natin, mga professor natin.
Ang galing talaga nila mag-edit, no?
Kaya happy Teacher's Day sa mga naging professor ko dyan since first year hanggang magiging ano na ako. Ngayong fourth year, mga magiging professor ko ngayong fourth year. So, ayan na, napanood na natin ang mga pagbati ng ating mga student leaders para sa mga professor sa Teacher's Day. And then, going back to the main event, first, I would like to greet all of the professors of Iris Manila a happy Teacher's Day. So, moving on, this is the real presentation of student organization. Habang hinihintay natin ma-present Ayun, meron na pala.
Greetings, students. We are all gathered here because we all have a goal that we are trying to aim, or an achievement that we have already heard. We're here to give you a rundown on what IRIS has to offer. Before all that, we would like to introduce the new Public Administration Society officer. For our president, we have Su Lan Yun. Just to speak also for our Vice President, Internal, we have Rafael Solero. And for our Vice President, External, we have Vincent Dino. Our Secretary and Assistant are Jessica Mitalis and Maria Agnes Inse. For our Treasurer and Auditor, we have Mark Polero and Marco Cotila. Lastly, we have our Representative, Frances Mirano as our second year, Mina Bascon as our third year representative, and also me, Jobert Sumaria, as our fourth year representative. That will be all. Thank you.
What is PAS? Most are curious about what the Public Administration Society is. The Public Administration Society, or PAS, is a CBO, or a college-based organization for bachelors of public administration. PAS represents and addresses the concerns of students enrolled in the public administration courses. PAS is also one who informs the students of the news, activities, and programs of our school and our department. So, PAS is also, it implements programs and projects to help students participate and show their talents. PAS is an organization that holds and connects with their higher-ups and teachers to inform their students' courses. The new administration of PAS aims to modernize the institution so that students can easily contact the administration with their concerns. To empower students' academic performance through public assistance and online services, involves public administration students in civic humanism and volunteerism. To motivate students to achieve their full potential in sports, academics, and leadership, to reinvigorate school clubs and pro-students organizations. To actively represent the students' diverse views, plans, and policies as a student body in society. To have effective dissemination of information and proliferation among students and other organizations, and to have a proper public disclosure of financial information and audited financial reports. For more information and concerns, you may contact and message the PAS administration by following and sending message to our Facebook page, Public Administration Society IRIS Chapter, or by emailing us at our Gmail account, pasiris@gmail.com. That is all. Thank you.
Good day to our beloved students. To begin with, we will recollect some of our successful stories, achievements, and accomplishments we have made for the year 2021-2022. At the very start, the public ni Amang unites. The unity of IRIS Public Administration was witnessed through DB Blast. As a result, students participated and enjoyed this activity. On to the next one. The College of Business and Public Administration successfully conducted a community extension program last December 18, 2021 with the theme CBPA Connected Care to Community. Public Administration Society was tasked to conduct a seminar entitled Values Restoration Workshop that was held on the same day at 12 p.m. where the audiences are the officials of Barangay 634 and 635. The activity continued. On December 22, 2021, selected PAS officers were invited. our BP External Justine Alambra and President Christine Jane Pabo, who said the show entitled Marites ng Pasko. In addition, one of the public administration students was able to showcase her talent in singing, Shaheen Priyaliana. We also note the expansion of our multimedia committee. We establish a production or multimedia committee. The PAS Multimedia Committee is a production club of Public Administration Society which is an expert in communication, develops and implements all the targeted contents for various media platforms. CPAT Suri Siyasat, an event partnership. On January 27, the Circle of Public Administration and Governance students or the Public Administration of Polytechnic University of the Philippines conducted an educational webinar entitled CPAT Suri Siyasat, a Local Governance Forum, an enlightening journal to discover and tackle the developments and practices in local governance and the significance of youth empowerment and their participation in shaping our nation. On February 15, we held Mr. and Ms. College of Business and Public Administration to showcase our beautiful and handsome students in public administration. We edited 10 videos of each public administration participants who partaken in the pageant on. Moreover, in honor of the 76th anniversary of the College of Business and Public Administration, last March 3, 2022, we conducted a debate competition with the topic Cyberbullying and Harassment in Learning Community. This activity provides awareness and allows a permanent record of negative information that has the potential to affect students' current and future psychological and emotional states. We encourage the PUBAD Niamang to be opinionated in this kind of topic by having this activity. Academic Achievers. As the semester comes to an end, we've witnessed students who have given their all and demonstrated their competitive nature. These students work extremely hard and push themselves to their limits. We posted an appreciation to every public administration student who are part of the Academic Achievers for first semester last April 11. We also prioritize webinars. With webinars, students can network with others in addition to learning new skills. Webinars can bring people from all over the world who are interested in learning together. As a result, students can network with like-minded individuals and support one another in their professions. In our first webinar this academic year 2021-2022, that was held on April 23, 2022, Saturday with the theme Good Governance, Pili PUBAD. This is in line with the past approaching national election happened in May 9, 2022. The webinar aims to reconstruct the values and critical thinking of our future public officials or administrators to achieve positive aspect and promote greater focus on the interests of the society by choosing the deserving leader as a start. Second webinar this academic year 2021-2022 was held on July 16, 2022, 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. via Google Meet and Facebook Live. This is in support to our graduating seniors, which serves also as their project. They have a webinar entitled Traits of a Public Servant Towards Effective and Efficient Public Service. CSO Election. From March 25 to March 29, we facilitated the election of every section under the public administration. Publicity Materials. To have a greater reach of the page, the Multimedia Committee made a set of posters consisting of announcements, reminders, greetings, and such. Lastly, we would like to acknowledge our partner organizations and event partner organizations. Junior Philippine Society for Public Administration. Philippine Society for Public Administration. Circle of Public Administration and Governance Students, Good Gov PH, and Philippine Institute for Development and Studies. Again, we, the Public Administration Society, para sa karunungan, katarungan, kalayaan. Commit to serve and act our commitment. We guarantee quality service and advance administration empowerment. And together we advance by inspiring change. And we provide comprehensive needs of the students who are in the same major. And bring them overall enhancement opportunities such as relevant transformation and growth development as future leaders. Thank you.
All right. So before we jump again to another part of the program, let's have the last information number again from the talent committee. So let's give a big a round of applause.
But still, before we have an intermission, kahit excited na kayo, may mga susunod pa. Bukod sa PAS, may mga susunod pang CBO organization.
Yes.
Siyempre, hindi papatalo yung ibang ano dyan, college-based organization. Papatalo ba yung ano, yung ibang CBO? Pass lang ba?
Mag-comment nga kayo.
So habang inaantay pa ang mga ibang CBO, mga presentation ng ibang CBO, magbabasa muna tayo ng mga kung buhay pa ba sila sa live chat natin sa YouTube.
Shout out guys, comment kayo.
Comment na habang inihintay natin yung ibang presentation pa nila.
Puro student po ba dito o mga teachers?
Both po, may student and may teachers po.
Ah, okay. Kala ko ako lang student dito.
So may nababasa ka na ba sa nagpapa-shoutout sa YouTube natin?
Wala sa YouTube eh, pero dito sa ating Zoom live meron dito si, hindi ko mabanggit ang kanyang pangalan, Almira Haji. Sabi niya, buhay pa po ang viewers.
Sabi naman ni Elio dito sa Zoom viewers natin, biggest struggle as a freshman. Siguro nung freshman ako, siguro yung mahabang pila tsaka yung init ng panahon. Yung sumaba, yung sahaba ng pila, tapos yung init pa ng panahon, nagsabay-sabay. Tapos aabutan ka paminsan ng cut-off. Diba? Yun yung masaklap as a freshman dati, nung face-to-face pa. Ikaw ba, nung freshman ka ba, ano bang ano mo partner, yung struggle mo?
Naku, yung cut-off sa ano sa online class partner. Pag hindi na kami nakapasok, wala na. Kasi hindi pa namin nararanasan mag-onsite partner.
Grabe.
Oh, so, ganun nga yun. Ganun yung struggle sa online.
Siguro nung face-to-face, madami ka talagang struggle kang mararanasan. Bukod pa yung aabutan ka ng cut-off.
Nako partner, parang kinakabahan na ako.
Kinakabahan ka na ba sa mga, ano, sa face-to-face na magaganap?
Nakakaba. By the way, shout out nga ba sa mga office administration diyan?
Shout out din sa mga ka-marketing ko diyan, ka-marketist ako. Pa-shout out daw sa CS Gym Head Multimedia, Ate Jeremy.
Opo. Pa-join po.
Tapos sabi dito sa chat box sa Zoom viewers natin, good luck sa F2F this coming November. Sayang skincare kung gano'n. Sobrang sayang talaga. Pangihinayang ka talaga. Sayang ang glass skin.
Magiging ano,
basag-basag na ang glass na skin.
Kasi masusunog ka talaga kung sakali. Tirik na tirik yung araw. So excited ka na ba sa darating na face-to-face partner?
Eh, syempre naman.
Habang inihintay ko din ang
inibot ko na ng aking pamasahe papunta sa aking school.
Grabe naman.
Mag-ipon. Oh, party ka
lang natin. Kailangan talaga mag-ipon, lalo na pagka malayo ang bahay mo.
Super. Manggagaling pa ng Rizal.
Ang layo niyan, partner.
Ang layo. Pero kailangan natin mag-aral lang mabuti at ipagpatuloy.
Tapos, dito naman tayo, dumayo naman tayo sa YouTube live natin. Live chat
ano,
natin.
Ano bang sabi ni Lenin, partner?
Sabi ni Rizalyn Limbaga, pa-shoutout po sa BSN Trep 1A. Mahal ko kayo. Grabe naman.
Uy, baka crush mo lang yun eh.
Sana all mahal. Joke lang. Sabi ni Alisa Ogario, pa-shoutout po sa BSOA 3C.
Wow.
3C. Sino pa nagpapa-shoutout? Habang may hinihintay tayo.
Habang hinihintay nyo ang ating ano, video.
Kasi hindi papatalo, bakit pass lang ba ang may video? Siyempre, ibang CBO din natin. Sabi naman ng nag-chat sa akin, hindi pa daw siya excited. Excited lang daw sa baon. Grabe naman yon.
Sa baon lang pala.
Baon lang pala siya excited. Hindi pala sa face-to-face. So, asan na ang ating CBO presentation?
Ayun na.
Oh, baby. to the first that was sent the same for me and you. Can you feel me? This is such a wonderful place to be. Even if there is pain now, everything will be alright. For as long as the world still turns, there will be night and day. Can you hear me? There's a rainbow always after the rain. Life's full of challenges, not all the time we get what we want. But don't despair, my dear. You'll take it, try.
Grabe, hindi ko ina-expect. Ako pala ang mag ang susunod. Na-shock ako doon. So, syempre, pagkatapos ng intermission, tuloy ulit natin ang presentation ng mga CBO.
Alright.
So habang hinihintay natin ang presentation, another shout out sa MM1B Almira, shout out sa BSBA Section 1B na magaganda, syempre. Sama mo na rin ang gwapo para fair lahat.
Aabangan natin 'yan sa school, sa darating na school.
Syempre,
aabangan natin tayo sa buong campus. Grabe yun, ang gagaling nila magsikanta.
Siyempre, magaling, ano, ako din. Bubuhati ko na bangko ko, partner.
Sample nga.
Ay, huwag mo ganyan muna. Hindi ako prepared ngayon.
Ay, hindi ba? Sige.
Hindi.
Sa pasukan. Sige. Magdadala tayo ng microphone sa school.
So, sabi dito, shout out. Shoutout sa YouTube live chat natin. Pa-shoutout po sa BPA 1B. Sana mapansin, please. Dilibre ko sila sa Save More pag treasurer na ako. Ay, grabe. Galante naman pala.
Grabe. Sino ba yan?
Grabe. Siyempre, tama mo kami sa paglibre. Dapat.
Ayan.
Balik na tayo ulit.
Greetings, freshmen. Welcome to the Entrepreneurial Management Society. We are eager to get to know each and every one of you, but today, we would like to tell all of you something about our organization. The EMS is proud to present our accomplishment.
Tutulog na ako.
Our organization is affiliated with the Young Entrepreneur Society Philippines, also known as YES. We have also been invited to various webinars managed by other organizations, such as the YAY webinar, PUP webinar, NKK webinar. The organization held a gift-giving event for the CBA Extension Program. For EMS Week, we had a successful bazaar and exhibit event. In Mr. and Miss CBA 2019, Miss Leslie Ladinez took the crown home to EMS. Furthermore, here are some other contestants from EMS. In 2022, Mr. Fernandez reached the top 5 and Miss Briones won the best in a futuristic costume. Aside from that, we're also the overall champions of CBA Sportfest 2020. For the business plan and case study competitions, EMS placed first and we get it to third place for financial statement competition. In the UMAC extemporaneous speech, Miss Parkin won as the first runner-up. Let's hop on to the introduction of the EMS officers for the academic year 2022 to 2023. Dr. Cynthia A. Manalad, EMS Chairperson. Professor Maria Teresa Madagan, EMS Advisor. Aaron Paul Cotidio, EMS President. Diana Rizal Martinez, Vice President Interna. Honey Vine Resurrection, Vice President External. J. Marie Pilapil, Secretary. Roslyn Pineda, Treasurer. Micaela Miralles, Auditor. Brenda Lee Salvador, Public Relations Officer. Mary Rose Pat, Public Relations Officer. Danielle Amponin, Business Manager. Arian Arinyego, Second Year Representative. Lee Ann Pangilinan, Third Year Representative. Aliana Erika Turco, 4th year representative. And now, I'm giving the floor to Professor Madaga.
Hi, good afternoon. On behalf of the Entrepreneurial Management Society, I would like to welcome our dear stakeholders. This coming school year, 2022-2023, we are facing a new challenge in life, which is the return of face-to-face classes. A new adjustment for all of us, but we know that we can get through it and we can return to whatever we did before the pandemic as long as we work together to achieve our goals and objectives. Our organization is open to all your inquiries and concerns. Just echo them to your class officer for immediate actions. Again, thank you and welcome to IRIS.
Presenting the Office Administration Society Officers, starting with Professor Jolly Joy B. Flora, the Office Administration Society Advisor. She is a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Office Administration and Master in Business Administration. She is also an OJT coordinator under the BSOA program. The Office Administration Society is composed of 13 officers, starting with Micaela Grace L. Martinez, the President of Office Administration Society. Mika D. Martinez, the Vice President Internal. Angelica Rodriguez, the Vice President External. Clarice Remedios Tizon, the Secretary. Maria Cristina Bonifacio, the Assistant Secretary. Jackie Lou R. Alada, the Treasurer. Rain F. Fernandez, the Auditor. Angeline A. Enriquez, the Business Manager. Kimberly Belen and Hart Pinico for the Public Relations Officers. And lastly, the representatives of Office Administration Society. For second year representative, Angelica L. Halorina. For third year representative, Abigail T. Pulvarosa. And Jamaica D. L. Insigne for fourth year representative. Here are the accomplishments of the organization for the last academic year, 2021 to 2022. The Create and Maintain Family Budget Seminar, the celebration of the Christmas Community Extension Program of the College of Business and Public Administration last December 18, 2020. The Colegio CBPA Quispy Competition and the celebration of 76th founding anniversary of the College of Business and Public Administration last March 2, 2022. And lastly, the Brigada last July 26, 2022, together with the other organization under the College of Business and Public Administration. As we begin our new academic year, a new journey awaits. Step in, stand out, start up. A stairway to success for the betterment of our new generations.
Human Resource Society. Accomplishment for the academic year 2021 to 2022. Executive Board Officers Academic Year 2021 to 2022. Affiliated school and national organization. National officers. JPMAP National Conference. Accreditation. CBPA Virtual Teachers Day Celebration. Simulation 2021. Participant in Earth Environmental Alleviation and Restoration through Humanity. Outstanding organization. JPMAP National Conference. JPMAP National Conference Episode 3. CBPA Community Extension Program. PUP Capital HR. HRSAP CSR Program Online Concert for a Cause. JP Map Got Talent. JP Map PLM Chapter. Seventy-sixth CBPA Founding Anniversary. Photo Contest.
And this year, 2022 to 2023, HRS will give you more.
So before we move on to another part of the program, I'd like to call on Professor Christian Andre Viril for his message.
Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. As the advisor of the JMS, I would like to describe our organization as a talent pool of creative students who are either hosts, performers, or future contenders. So may take the opportunity to invite, you can reach out to any of our officers. Thank you.
Partner, nakamute ka ata, partner.
Okay.
Ayan, okay na.
Okay na?
Yes, meron nang sound.
Okay, thank you CBO for a wonderful presentation.
Nawala.
Okay na ba?
Ayan.
Meron na.
Saan tayo na hinto? Sorry for the problem. Saan tayo na hinto?
Sa video, after ng video.
After mag-message ni Sir Beryl?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Opo.
Thank at naglolo ko ang aking mic for today's event. So, thank you.
Partner, mukhang nawawala talaga ang ating mic. Wait lang po natin.
Siguro habang... parang
ayan.
Uber mo na muna. I got it. Okay. Rinig na ba?
Ayan. Meron na, partner.
Okay.
Rinig na.
So we are now approaching to the last part of our event. But before that, I'd like to introduce Dr. Chanda Tinga, our dean and the CBPA SD advisor.
To our college dean, Dr. Willie Ogapasi, to the area chairs of the different programs, faculty members, students, student leaders of the different organizations, special mention to the new students with their parents, a pleasant day to everyone. I want to start these closing remarks with the words, step in and welcome to the College of Business and Public Administration. Stand out, my dearest students, and let us start up, my dear colleague. It is tough to have closing remarks at the opening of the class. I want you, my dear students, to close your eyes and hold on to the man above in times of fear, worry, and uncertainty. Everything is uncertain at this point. There is a little girl in the fire and dark smoke on the top of the building. His father wanted to save him, so he instructed her to jump. She replied, "I am afraid. I do not see you." But his dad answered, "I see you. What you need is to jump." She jumped and saved. Let us learn from the stories as your second parents to bear with our instructions and learn to trust us as appointed by God. Above all, trust His love, who sees our problems and situations in times of darkness and His mighty power to save us. Secondly, the lesson is for us teachers to be the savior and not hilarious in times of confusion. Let us step in, stand out, and start to face the new pace of our life in the face of God. Thank you, and God bless us all.
All right. Thank you so much. So let's proceed. So acknowledgement. So good afternoon, everyone. I would like to give our utmost gratitude to Dr. Edita Pilio, the president of school, and to our vice president of academic affairs, Dr. Frederick Peña, and also to our college dean, Dr. Willie Ogopasin, for tirelessly supporting us. And especially to our CBPA, SG advisor and associate dean, Dr. Chanda Tinga, for guiding and giving motivate to everything. To our CBPA faculty for sharing valuable knowledge. To college student government who organize of this activity and show hard work to make this successful. So be also thankful to the college-based organizations, Junior Marketing Society, Human Resource Society, Public Administration Society, Office Administration Society, Entrepreneurial Management Society, who supported us and helped us make this program successful. And of course, to all CBPA students, thank you for support, time, and effort. Partner?
So before we end this YouTube live, may request to everyone for the photo opportunity to open up all your cameras and wear your biggest smile. Patanggal ko yung presentation. Okay, thank you. Okay, open up your cameras na.
Naglalabasan na ang mga
nagdagandaan at gagwagwapuhan natin yung mga professor. Okay.
Kaway-kaway kayo. Baka dyan yung professor nyo.
Hello guys. So, kindly open your camera po for documentation lang. Ayan. 3, 2, 1. Smile. One more. Ayan. 3, 2, 1. Ayan. Okay na po. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, okay. Thank before you. We end this program, to lead the closing prayer, may I call on the chief interpreter, Professor Ronald Doroteo.
As we end this day, let us put ourselves into the holy presence of God in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for the work of this day. We may find gladness in all its toil and difficulty. its pleasure and success, and even its failures and sorrows. Help us to look always away from ourselves and behold the glory and the need of the world, that we may have the will and the strength to bring the gifts of gladness to others, that with them we stand to bear the burden in the heat of the day and offer you the praise of your work for the earth and all its people. Through Christ our Lord, amen. May the Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
So, thank you everyone for participating in our simulation program 2022. Good luck for your new journey. Do the best you can until you know better.
Then when you know better, do better. Bye-bye and thank you.
Bye.
And bye, guys.
Have a great day, guys.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
We can build joy.